my channel. So in today's video, I'm doing this makeup look as per usual, same old intro. I wanted to play around with like the plummy kind of tones and like the burnty reds. I don't know what you would call these colors, and I don't know what I'm calling it. But anyway, I love this finished product. It's like super full coverage with the foundation, lots and lots of highlight, and yeah, the eyes are popping, the lips are popping, everything's there, sister. Anyway, I hope you enjoy the video and let's get started. So the same as last week, I'm starting off with a fresh, clean face and Z-brows already done. So my primer I'm going to use is the Napoleon Radiance Primer because I want my skin to be glowing like no other. And to get that super glowy finish, I'm going in with this Napoleon Highlighter. It's like a cream stick, and I'm using my finger to apply this on the highest points of my face before I put my makeup on. This is gonna make it look like I'm glowing from within, and it's kind of like a bit of a double highlight because I'm still gonna do it after makeup as well. For foundation today, I'm using my Stila Stay All Day. This stuff is just such a beautiful finish, and the coverage is amazing and just spreads and makes your skin look like skin. I love it. I've only got it in one shade, which is honey, which is why I don't use it that often because I'm really never tanned anymore. And for concealer, I'm going to be using the one that comes with the foundation. This is a really good color. As you guys might know, I do like to layer and double up my concealers. So I'm not going to set it just yet, as later on I will go in with a second one. And I'm using that on my eyelids as a base also. And now I'm just setting my face with my Napoleon Camera Finish in Look 4. To warm up my skin and contour, I'm going in with the MAC Studio Fix Pressed Powder in NC45. It's a super dark shade, but it's quite a yellow golden undertone, which is perfect for if you have a fake tan on, exhibit A like myself. So I am just putting quite a full amount of that under my cheekbones to give a chiseled look, and then I'm going around the temples and forehead and under the chin. As always, this is how I always contour. And taking any cream matte colored eyeshadow as a base for our eyeshadows. And now I'm taking MAC Woodwinks. This is one of my favorite eyeshadows. It's like a really beautiful bronzy soft brown, and I'm putting this all over my mobile lid, and then I'm softly blending it into the crease and just building that color up until you're happy with how intense it looks. You could totally just do this color on its own and then a wing liner and lashes. It's such a quick and easy way to do an eye technique. And now I'm taking MAC Saddle just to give me some warmth through the crease. I'm not actually putting this over the mobile lid. I'm just using it to blend out Woodwinked. And now I'm taking MAC Coppering, and this is where we're going to get all of our warmth. I'm using this majority through the crease of the eye just to give it a really kind of burnt, sexy orange reflect. I don't want it everywhere because I want it to be brown, blended into coppering, blended into brown, if that makes sense. And now I'm taking MAC Nylon to highlight the center of my mobile lid. And as I said, I do like to double up on my concealers, so I'm taking the Maybelline Age Rewind to do a strong V and using it to tidy up the corner of my eyeshadow and make it nice and sharp. Then I'm blending it in with my Real Techniques Damp Beauty Blender. To set that in place immediately, I'm using Laura Mercier Secret Translucent Brightening Powder. As always, this is the only setting powder that I can use under my eyes that doesn't make me look tired or cracked. It's amazing. Now taking Napoleon Amazon Jungle Eyeshadow, and I'm just using it to blend out the eye and make everything look really seamless from the crease to the brow bone. And this look is so perfectly finished off with a dramatic wing liner. I just love these eyeshadows with a strong wing liner. So this is what I'm doing here. And and just making sure that the eyeliner is nice and even on both eyes. Then I'm going to be tight lining, which is lining up the top on the inside, and applying the eyeliner to the inner rim at the bottom also. And now I'm taking an angled brush and the eyeshadow coppering to smoke out the liner at the bottom. And now taking Saddle and doing the exact same thing. And using the same eyeshadow again, Nylon, to highlight the inner tear ducts of the eyes. And now I'm just taking any neutral beigey kind of colored eyeshadow to really blend out this section here. I just want it to look super blended onto the brow bone. And now I'm going back into the eyeshadow Woodwinked and I'm making it super smoky at the bottom of my eyes. I'm actually using a slightly bigger brush this time. I just like it to look really faded and I like it to be taken down quite far so there's a nice gradient. Now moving on to blush, I'm using this color disc called Sugar Plum and I'm just smiling and heavily applying that to the apples of my cheeks and then blending it up on top of my cheekbone. And going back into this cream stick highlighter and I'm going to highlight exactly where I did it before, the highest points of my face, using my finger to warm up the product as always and just patting that over the top. I did say I wanted an extreme highlight, so I'm layering it up. Now I'm having a bit of a grind on the chair by the looks of it, using the Becca Champagne Pop highlight just over my cheeks and down the bridge of my nose. Applying a very quick coat of my Dior Show mascara. I'm putting falsies on anyway, so it doesn't really matter. I'm using the Red Cherry False Lashes in the design 747M. They're the most beautiful, natural, fluffy looking lash, so I do tend to use them quite often. And once you've got the lash in place and you are happy with it, be sure to squeeze the tweezers with your natural lashes so they kind of grip together and come out almost naturally. And then use the base of your tweezers to press them up so they are really curled and sitting upwards. And for the lips, I wanted to do something nice and warm and wintry. You could definitely do a nude lip or probably even a red or almost any colored lip. But I thought I would take MAC Spice Lip Liner and then Napoleon Olympia Lipstick. It's just a really cool combo and it just matches the eyes perfectly. So yeah, that brings me to the end of the tutorial. I hope you guys loved it. As always, don't forget to subscribe and I'll see you next week. Bye. Love you.